software engineering skills.
Our collaboration is centered around
trying to make this video. Hi, my name is Ivan Simic and I'm a data engineer at Nordeus.
Hi, my name is Michał Warchalski and I'm a data scientist at Nordeus.
At Nordeus, being a part of the data engineering team means making terabytes of unprocessed data that come from our games every day available for everyone inside a company.
Data scientists at Nordeus work closely with product and marketing teams and support them with tools and insights based on statistics and machine learning.
With our platform, we make sure that every team can make data-informed decisions and perform all kinds of advanced analysis, even without requiring any programming or SQL knowledge.
Working as a marketing data scientist, my main objective is to try to quantify the impact of marketing campaigns according to the quality of players that we bring into the game. For that, I'm using the data stored in our warehouse, which is managed by our data engineering team.
Data engineering involves machine learning. No. Data engineering does not involve machine learning, but we do build tools to help data scientists create and build machine learning models.
We provide insights using data, which are usually in the form of analysis or reports, as well as statistical tools, which make the life of our teams easier in the day-to-day work.
Data engineering involves extracting value from data. No. But we do transform and structure our data in such a way that makes it easier for other teams to obtain value from it.
While we have to work in sync in order to make sure that the necessary data is provided by the data engineering team for the data scientists to work with, we essentially concentrate on different components of the data to insight pipeline. Some questions that data scientists try to answer are, for how long should we run an A/B test for a new game feature in order to obtain statistically significant results? And what metrics should we track?
How to organize our data to satisfy the requirements that our data teams have?
How can we offer the best value to our players by personalizing the in-game offers?
How to optimize the performance and to make that data easy to query?
How to optimize the marketing spend in order to balance the low acquisition cost together with targeting the most interested audience?
How to store our data in an efficient and cost-effective way? I studied computer science and informatics at School of Electrical Engineering in Belgrade, which I think it's a great showcase of different software engineering fields.
I started off my career as a mathematician working in academia, and I never really considered working in industry. However, at some point, I decided that I would prefer to use my skills to serve more real-world problems. I decided to apply and work for Nordeus due to interesting and challenging analytical problems of mobile gaming, as well as due to company's culture.
My interest in data engineering started at my first job when I noticed just how important data is for business and how much hidden knowledge lies in it, and I wanted to be a part of that process.
For the background that you need to become a data scientist, there is no single way. But experience with more quantitative fields such as mathematics, physics, computer science or finance, as well as experience or motivation to learn some programming will definitely help. Data scientists work with the data stored in our warehouse, while data engineers make sure that the necessary data is available and cleaned in the warehouse. Our collaboration is centered around identifying what data should be stored and how it should be structured, as well as creating tools for accessing the data in an automated way, such as scheduled machine learning pipelines.
Besides being used for analyzing data, our platform is also used for training machine learning models. These models are written by our data scientists, and they are, for example, being used for optimizing players' in-game experience or for making our user acquisition more cost-effective. Data engineers collaborate with almost every team. We place a high emphasis on data safety. Since most of the unprocessed data come from the actions that users make in our games, we work closely with the game teams to make sure that they follow strict data safety guidelines. This way, our players' data is secure. We also frequently communicate with our marketing team. They often need to have third-party data collected and organized internally, so they have everything they need in one place, and that is our data platform.
Data scientists support product and marketing teams very closely. In the case of product, it is usually related to testing new features as well as optimizing in-game offers and events, while making sure that we improve the user experience. For marketing, the problems are usually linked to estimating the long-term lifetime value of players, measuring app virality, as well as optimizing audience targeting in order to better understand the actual value of money spent on the campaigns.
We make it possible for game teams to be able to use our data in a much more simple and creative manner. We made data even more accessible for different tech and non-tech teams by creating tools for easily tracking data metrics.
Every new game feature has to be properly tested, and any offer we display to our players has to be personalized so that we keep them happy. And this is where data science comes into play. Moreover, a large portion of our player base is brought to the game by marketing campaigns. And this is why reaching the most interested audience is crucial. This is where data science team joins forces with the marketing team to optimize audience targeting.
The other impact of data engineering can be seen through scalability and saving money and time for our game teams. In a live game such as Top 11, we're continuously handling and managing a vast amount of data in form of events. And when designing our data pipelines, there is something that we need to take into consideration. New features are being constantly added to our games. Because of this, we need to make sure that our data platform has all its flexibility it needs to adapt to this constant change.
On one hand, there are lots of active players who generate plenty of data every day, which makes the process of analyzing the impact of any changes in the game or marketing campaigns very fast-paced.
Our games have lots of different live events, and our product managers want to see how they perform as soon as possible. That's why we also need to make sure that live data can be accessed within minutes of their generation.
On the other hand, which is quite specific to the free-to-play market, the revenue is driven by only a couple of percent of players, whose distribution has to be very well understood. I really like to bridge the gap between theoretical knowledge such as math or statistics and real-world problems that we're dealing with every day.
Data engineering is still a pretty new field. There are no concrete best practices for most things, as the industry is still trying to agree on them. That means that you have all the freedom you need to build custom platforms and workflows, and that is something that is pretty exciting.
What I also really enjoy is that gaming is a very interdisciplinary field, and in order to solve problems efficiently, I always have to strive for business context while working with people across many different roles at Nordius.
Try to get yourself familiar with the fundamentals of cloud computing, for example, in Google Cloud Services, in Microsoft Azure or AWS. Most of them provide courses for big data or data warehouse topics.
If you feel that you have a strong scientific background, try to research or imagine what types of problems you'll be working on in the industry, for example, via some own projects or Kaggle datasets. If you rather come from a less quantitative background, don't shy away from understanding the relevant statistical tools in more depth. Even if you're not gonna implement everything from scratch, you'll need a good understanding of them sooner or later in order to use them properly.
And don't forget the basics. Play with SQL and expand general database knowledge.
And last but not least, never neglect your coding skills.